championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. With a little Lakers trade news coming from Mark Stein's Substack. Definitely worth a subscription there, and involves Russell Westbrook. According to Stein, the Lakers have a deal on the table right now to trade Russell Westbrook. I'm going to dive into whether or not they should actually do this in just a minute. But first, quick reminder, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to ring that notification bell as well. All right. According to Stein, this is the deal, and he has been all over this particular rumor for a while now. It's Russell Westbrook to the Houston Rockets for John Wall and the Lakers 2027 first round pick. That is the deal that is on the table. And according to Stein, the Lakers up to this point have said no. They are not willing to include the first round pick. And for a variety of reasons, and frankly, they're all the same reasons that we've been talking about right here on this channel. Number one, the Lakers don't have any certainty that John Wall is better than Russell Westbrook. John Wall has not played since last year. You can say skill set wise, maybe Wall might be a little bit of a better fit, but is it worth sacrificing your biggest asset that you've got right now, the 2027 first round pick, in order to gamble that Wall, who again, we haven't seen play since last season, is currently better than Russell Westbrook? The Lakers think that's too much of a price to pay. On top of that, the optics around the situation, to suddenly have to pay a first rounder to get rid of Russell Westbrook when you just gave up all the stuff that you had to part with in order to get him not all that long ago. Kyle Kuzma, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, Montrezl Harrell, the 22nd pick in this last year's draft, all of that stuff parted with in order to get Russell Westbrook and some second round picks. That doesn't look good. The optics of that looks very bad for the Lakers. So that's something the front office has to be aware of. And they're factoring in that LeBron, AD, and Russ haven't played that many games together on the season because AD and LeBron have both been dealing with things like injuries, of course, suspension, things like that have kept them from being together as a trio for the vast majority of the season. So the Lakers say, you know what, let's give this some time and find out what we've really got. So Stein says the Lakers at this point are approaching things as though they are going to keep Russ for the remainder of the season. During the offseason, Russell Westbrook, assuming he picks up that $47 million player option, he will be a free agent the following season, which makes him an expiring contract to potentially use in a deal this offseason. So perhaps if the Lakers decide to part ways with him then, if it's just still not working, the fit's just not there, then they can do so next summer. But Stein did leave open the possibility. We are still a little ways away from the trade deadline. It's coming up on February 10th that this could be revisited. Stein mentioned that as of this moment, this is a no-go, the 2027 first-round pick. But if maybe a third team is rounded in order to improve an offer somewhere, in order to change things up, maybe that could be a path towards getting something done. Or if the Rockets come off of their ask for a first-round pick, what if the Rockets suddenly say, okay, we'll do it for a second-round pick? Then do the Lakers consider it? Now, again, we haven't seen John Wall play in over a year now. Well, a season anyway. The Lakers, though, if anybody's going to know what kind of shape John Wall is in, and by the way, he's not even with the Rockets. He's training in Miami. But if anybody's going to know what kind of shape John Wall is in, that's not the Houston Rockets, it's the Lakers. John Wall is a Clutch Sports client. I'm sure Rich Paul is keeping the Lakers very well informed of exactly what kind of shape John Wall is in. So they're going to have some idea of what it is that they're getting. Perhaps if the asking price comes down a little bit, maybe there's a deal to be had there. But as of this moment, the Lakers say the 2027 first, that's a no-go, and I don't blame them. I'm in full agreement. I think that is way too much. I think that's the Houston Rockets trying to take advantage of perceived desperation on the part of the Los Angeles Lakers. A first-round pick, to me, is bonkers to think about giving that up just to swap out Russell Westbrook for John Wall. Remember, to the Houston Rockets, there's no difference. Their salaries are the same. Paying John Wall to stay at home isn't going to be any different to the Rockets than paying Russell Westbrook to stay at home. And in fact, it might even be a little bit better for them, because the word is that Russ might be willing to do a buyout if he was traded to the Houston Rockets, whereas John Wall is not. John Wall wants all of his money and is not willing to get bought out. So the Rockets, to me, asking for a first-round pick, that's too much. I understand Houston saying we need to get something. Maybe eventually they'd come to terms on a second-round pick or something like that. But for now, I don't see a lot of incentive for the Lakers to do this deal to move Russell Westbrook if they have to give up their 2027 first. So I think this is a smart decision for the time being by the Lakers front office. But give me your take. What do you think? Should the Lakers do that? Russell Westbrook plus attach a first round pick, the only tradable first round pick that they've got, put that in order to get John Wall back from the Houston Rockets. Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.